Let's continue. We're continuing with the Sefer Shevi Yibol Tzadik in Perek Aleph in page 20. We want to continue of the importance of being able to be Oisik B'Torah. In that way, you're going to be able to remove the suffering. So the Shevi Yibol Tzadik, he writes over here, Ve'alken, and therefore, Asherav L'mishi Usurim Ba'im Lo Min HaTorah. Praiseworthy is the person that his suffering comes through Torah, meaning by sitting and learning Torah. Shehi chayenu v'or chimenu, because this is our days and our lives. V'zehu kavanat atana, shekol amikabel alav ol ma'ol Torah. This is what the kavanah of the Tana, what he had. Anybody who accepts upon himself the yoke of Torah, ma'avirin memenu, they're going to remove from him ol ma'achud v'ol derech eretz. They're going to remove from him the yoke of the government and the yoke of work. It is very fit, it's very proper to make these words very great. To young boys who are in Shiva. Also us, Rabotai. That they're looking for pleasure and good times. Because a person needs to understand all this very good. The more a person is going to toil in Torah with self-sacrifice, and he's going to pain himself a little bit to try to overlook his pleasures or his ta'avot. For example, a person has an option right now to go to sleep. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, he says, I'm going to push myself to learn Torah. But you have the ta'avot, you have the desire to sleep, or you have the desire to eat, and you have the option to learn Torah. What are you going to do? He says a person should try to go ahead with self-sacrifice and try to pain himself a little bit and overlook his sleep, overlook the food for a second. Give yourself 5-10 minutes and you'll see how much shiata the Shema you're going to have. Kach yikabel ba'atid yoter v'yoter, rabotai. Anybody who learns Torah be misirut nefesh, with self-sacrifice, and he, with little effort, he tries to remove his wants, his wills, this way he's going to be able in the future to get much more back as a reward. Because on every person it's already decreed how many pleasures he's going to be able to get in this world. Guys, Rabotai, listen to this carefully. Not only is the Torah going to pay you back in this world, Rabotai, for the pleasures that's going to give you, just the opposite. When a person learns Torah, you think you're losing something. I'm losing sleep, I'm losing, having a good time. Yeah, people think these good times. Rabotai, just the opposite. When a person learns Torah, on the contrary, it's going to give you much, much more pleasures in this world. Ve'alken, and therefore, Ashram, praiseworthy. Limish, Yusirim Bam Lo Mina Toiro. Praiseworthy is the person that his suffering comes through the Torah. Ve'chol ze baraita mefureshet. All this is in the open baraita. Eilu devarim shadam oseh otam. Right, we say it every morning, Rabotai. These are the things that a person does them. Oh, help me, priyotehem ba'olam hazeh, va'keren kayemet lo la'olam haba. You eat the fruits of your labor in this world, and the root of the reward you're going to get in the next world. While we conclude, v'tamud Torah keneged kulam, Rabotai. Learning Torah is against all the mitzvahs in the Torah. V'haynu she'en davar she'yitein la'adam perot v'hana'ot, kan ba'olam hazeh yoter me'atorah kedushah. There is nothing in this world, I don't care what you want to think of, there is nothing in this world that's going to give a person pleasure and happiness and simcha in this world more than the Torah Kedoshah. You can think this will bring you pleasure, this will bring you pleasure, Rabotai. All those things are only fleeting pleasures. 2 minutes, 10 minutes, 6 months, sometimes 2 weeks, Rabotai. We all know it. We get a new car, 2 months we already get sick and tired of it, right? When you start eating a certain food, you eat too much of it, you become sick and tired of it. Rabotai, but when it comes to learning Torah, no matter how much Torah you learn, it's only going to increase for you to want to learn. Why? Because it's not fleeting; it's for eternity. Umikra malihu, and it's a full pasuk in the Torah, like the pasuk says, "Re'e anochi noten lefnechem hayom bracha uklala et abracha asher tishmu el mitzvot Hashem Elohecha ve'aklala im lo tishmu." Rabotai, Hashem says, "Open, Rabotai. I put before you blessings and curses." And Hashem says, please, do me a favor, choose the blessings. Go in my ways, go in my mitzvot. Learn my Torah, know what to do. If not, Chas V'Shalom, Rabotai, I do not want to continue saying it. ועוד העריך בזה הקרנה דאיגרתה, שכל הניסיונות והצער וההגיעות שיש לאדם על ידי עסק התורה, all the tests, all the pain, all the toiling that a person has when he toils in the Torah, הוא המביא לבסוף להצלחה הגדולה. In the end, you're going to be very successful. Why? Because it's not upon you to finish. Your job is to try, and in the end, Hashem will make you successful. וכל מה שעלה לו בהגיע וצער, anything that came up to your hand with toil and pain, הוא רכוש עצום ונורא, it's great wealth. ומאומה לא יישא מהעולם הזה לעולם הבא זולת עבודת הבורא יתברך. רבותיי, let's do this carefully. In this world, transferring things to the next world, רבותיי, you're not taking with you anything. Not even a pair of socks, not even a pair of shoelaces. The only thing that's going with you is avodat haboreit barach, only in serving Hashem. When you're going to serve Hashem, that's the only thing that you're going to take with you. So a person has to make the cheshbon. Is it kadai for me now to go ahead and waste my time on idle things, on nonsense in the world, than to give up learning Torah? Why, rabotai? Because you have to understand. Put it to you like this. A person wants to watch 3 hours of TV, correct? 3 hours of TV. How is that going to help you in Olam Haba? Can you tell me? Not even that. Oh, Ora. Yeah, you feel good now. You feel good in the 3 hours, only to feel like garbage after the 3 hours. For how long? It's going to bother you. Shacharit, Mincha, Ravit. You're not going to be able to be focused. Rabotai, but when you learn, had you learned in those 3 hours, it would have given you Simcha, Bracha, Parnasa, everything. You would have been able to continue the day, and whatever you would touch, everything would become gold. But what the Yitzhar knows is, the Yitzhar knows that the secret is where? Where's the secret? In fighting us where the Torah is. That's why when the angel fought, with who did he fight? With Yaakov Avinu. What happened to Abraham? What happened to Yitzchak? What, they're not important to Chas V'Shalom? What happened? Why chose on Yaakov? You ready? Abraham, he was, right, he always had guests. Chesed. Yitzchak, prayer. But what did Yaakov Avinu do? Torah. All he did was sit and learn Torah, correct? So what did Chachamim tell us? The Yetzar said, do Hachnasat Orchim as much as you want. I'm not diminishing, it's a very big thing. But the Yetzar said, the Malach said, do as much as you want Hachnasat Orchim. Do as much as you want Tefillah. But one thing don't do, don't learn Torah, you know why? Because once you learn Torah, that is the master key for everything in this world. So Rabotai, as you guys know, there were three, my wife showed me, also my brother showed me that there were three Gedolim Nifter in one day. Rahman Salom and four of them. I don't know these things, fine. Okay, four. Rabotai, whatever, three, four, doesn't matter, Rabotai. I want to put it like this. For all the young kids out there, for all the young teenagers, for people that are still under the age of 80, I'm not even without exaggeration, Rabotai. It's never too late to become a Talmid Chacham. Even if you're 100 years old, Rabotai, it is never too late to become a Talmid Chacham. I want to show you what's going on. Ever since this Corona thing started, Loleinu, this COVID-19 business, how many Gedolim did we lose? How many of them do you know? How many big ones did we lose? I'm not going to try to give you answers to why this is happening. But one thing I want to try to do, try to bring out an awareness, Rabotai, we have an achrayut to learn Torah much more. Why? Because now that they're gone, Rabotai, the world will be much, much more in danger if there's no Torah. When we learn Torah, you not only protect yourself, but you protect the whole world. So don't be selfish. Don't think about your football games and your TV shows and your friends and your family. Rabotai, start worrying about Klal Yisrael. Start learning Torah, Rabotai. You've been learning up to now 2 hours, make it 4 hours. I guarantee you're not going to die. If anything, you're going to live a longer life. Baruch Adonai L'Olam. Amen v'amen. Rabbi Hanan ben Yechon.